Hello guys, KP Shamino here with my first video for a new game that I'm playing at the moment. So I'm playing now Carp Fishing Simulator for I think 4 or 5 days. And I know a lot of people in Europe like to fish for carp, and it's really carp fishing. So you can get other fish too, but it's with beepers. It's with like a line that is like, sitting on the same place the whole time until the beeper goes off. A lot of carp setups and all that stuff. So it's really, focused on, carp fishing. And that's normal because the name is Carp Fishing Simulator. So the thing is, this game is created by one guy. So only one guy is making this game. And I think he did not a bad job. It's not graphical the best game. It's not physical rot action the best game. But the thing is that you always want to come back. Why? Because there is a very big fish in the game. I saw a 47 kilogram carp. And so they go very, very high. So you want to come always back to get that fish. It's not that easy to get the fish here. So that's the goal. In a game, you always need to have a goal. If you don't have a goal, people don't come back. So, but the guy is working very hard at the moment because he got now a 3D animator. And he's making new models for the fish. He's working on the physics, he's working on Bobber. So you can check it out on the forum. So I'm expecting that we are going to get an update really soon. So I'm not sure because it's only one guy. So it can take maybe some weeks or months still. But he's always updating too. So he makes YouTube videos about what he's doing at the moment. He's talking a lot on the forums. If you ask something, he answers. So you always know what is happening in the game. So now I'm going to show you guys some gameplay, just a little bit in-game stuff. So let's get started. So first of all, it's very straight. So I got profile now. And here in the profile, you can see the fish that is in the game. So you got a common carp, you got a mirror carp, you got a grass carp, you got a ghost koi, catfish, sturgeon, pike, perch, bream, Tench and Zander. So that's what you get into the game. And you got always, you're always compared with the leaderboard with other players that play this game. So it's not that the leaderboard reset, but you can see what other guys got. It's of course, once again, you got the maximum fish. I saw on the yellow perch 2.7 kilogram. So I'm almost at the maximum. So it's the same like in Fishing Planet. At some point, they are limited. But on the biggest carp, I only saw two guys that got the maximum, if that is the maximum. So it seems it's not that easy to get those fish. I'm not sure where they are because I'm still in the starting zone. I don't think that they are over there. I think I need to go to the next zones. But that's later on. If you get a fish, you get coins, and with those coins, you buy stuff. And I'm going to show you guys what you can buy in this game. So just go to the tackle shop. It's not a lot. It's not, don't expect 5,000 kind of lures, 5,000 rods. No, no. It's just 3 rods that you can buy. I got now my second one. So you can fish with 3 rods at the same moment. You can get a spot rod. I'm not sure what that is, but if I got it, I'm going to try it out. You got the marker rod, you got tents, they call it biffies, so that are the biffies. I'm not sure that they are to any use. I think they are just, you can put it on the packs, but I don't think that, it's just a little bit design or decor around. So I'm not sure that they are used for something, but it's cool. Then you got the alarms, and then you got a bait boat. I'm going to make a video about the bait boat if I got it, because I need 3,000 coins for it, and it takes some time to farm the coins. To give you an example, a 4 kilogram common carp gives like 80 coins. So, And I think that's a little bit the biggest one that I can get in the starting zone, so it takes some time. Then you got here a depth finder, so a fish finder, and then you got a carp grendel too. That's to put your fish on and take a photo. So it's not a lot, it's straight on, but it doesn't need to be always very complicated. I think this is straight on, but you can get very big fish. That's what is important. If I go to venues, those two lakes, you can go right away. So you got Pine Tree Lake, you got Heaven, and that are the lakes that unlock. And I think that I'm going to find the very big pikes, the very big carps over here. But I need 5,000 coins, so it's going to take some time. But I always put it on my second screen this game, and if I hear my beepers going off, I just go to check and I'm going to get the fish, and then I'm playing the other game further. Because if you need to play this game only and you need to sit the whole time and watch your beepers, it can take some time. It depends. Sometimes you got like 10 bites after each other right away, and sometimes it takes a lot of time. So yeah, it's a simulator. It's a simulator. So it's something different than Fishing Planet. Here you need to wait. You don't know what you are getting. So I think at some point, if I got the biggest fish, it's a little bit done this game for me, because why are you fishing still? It's a lot of random stuff that is going to happen. So at some point it stops, but I think that you can easily go 50 to 100 hours with fun, and then you are at the maximum. Then you need to wait, but it's only 12 euros, so it's not a lot of money that you need to spend. And yeah, I think it's worth it. I already got 20 hours into the game, I think, so it's more than worth it. So it's going to take some time. You just need to pay it once and then you can fish. There is no license system and all that crap. That's not in this game. So yeah, that's my next goal. So to go to those lakes. So let's close this stuff and let's start fishing. So let's go fishing. You got at the moment 7 lakes, but one lake is still in construction. That's here in Spain, and it's going to be the Catfish Lake. So yeah, massive catfish are incoming. If you know that the biggest carp in the game is 100 pound, 50 kilograms. So yeah, the catfish, I think they are even bigger in real life. So are we going to get a catfish that is 100 kilograms? I don't know. We need to watch until it's released. I'm always fishing in Pine Tree Lake. For common mirror grass and koi carp, tench, bream, and perch pike. I got everything here except the pike. So we need to wait a little bit that I can get it. So I'm just building up my stash of coins. So let's go to the Pine Tree Lake. Let's fish here. Normally, if you got a little bit more gear as I do, you can get your stuff on, so I don't have a bivy, so now I cannot click anything because I don't have any equipment. So let's go. So now we are into the game, and to be honest, this game I was expecting it to be a little bit more, yeah, how can I say it, bad on the graphics, but it doesn't look that bad in my opinion. If you check the water looks really cool. So it's graphical wise not that bad. So what you need to do now is you just need to find the pech. So it's not that I can fish here. No, you need to stand on this. These are the pech areas, and here is already a guy fishing. So I'm not sure that they are really online players or it's just random. So it's possible that they are real players, but I'm not sure. I don't know. So here is the car park, and yeah, let's fish here. So what I'm going to do now you need to push enter. By the way, after this, I'm going to make a video, or this week, I'm going to make a video purely on the mechanics. So a beginner's guide, what key you need to use and all that stuff. I don't want to do that in this video because otherwise, yeah, it's going to be more a guide than a first look or a review or like a gameplay video. You guys know that. I want to go to a video that is not that long. 5 minutes with all the basic mechanics keys in it, and it's a lot easier for you guys too. So what I do the whole time is I make a rig for a carp and I make a rig for predators, so for the perch and the pike. So all this stuff is real stuff. So I didn't know what it was, so I needed to Google it. And if you Google it, for example, a blowback rig, it's in real life, it's existing. So it's real rigs that you can use. So if you don't know what the rig is, just Google it and there you know it. I'm always going with the snowman rig. It's like two things. It's like a weight, I think, and above the weight there is the bait. So it's a snowman. Yeah, how can I say, two balls on each other. So therefore they call it. And I'm always going, the bait is real life too. It exists. If you to this active bait Krilla. You will see how it looks. So let's go with the Krilla. Let's take the biggest bait. This is the size of the bait. So I always go with the big one. I put it to send to rod one. So this setup is done. There is no visual that you can check it out. No, it's not going to happen in this game. This is just the rod. You only can see it here, what is on the rod. Then for the second setup, I always go with like worm or something, or with like dead bait. So with real bait for predators. So let's try dead bait sardine. Let's go with 18 millimeter and send it to rod 2. So now my setup is ready to get used. So now you will see here, and this is typical carp setup. The guys that fish for carp, they always use this setup. They are sitting in their tent, masturbating a little bit until they got a beeper bite, and then they get the fish in. So what we are going to do now is I'm going to pick up my rod one. I'm going to throw rod one. I totally forgot what rod one was. Ah, it's active bait. So I'm going to throw it over there. There you go. Let's put it back in. And the second one I throw over here because I know in this position on the lilies I get a lot of yellow perch and I'm getting a lot of bream. So therefore I'm going to throw it over there. And predators like lilies, carp like lilies too, for the vegetation. It's dropping on the ground and they like to eat. So let's throw it here. And there you go. So now you need to wait. And it can take some time sometimes. So I'm going to do a little bit of magic, YouTube magic, in this video now. Okay, guys, I got now a bite, and this is a good bite. You guys can see it. So let's try to get this fish. Yeah, and I got him on. So now the thing is, you guys, that's what I said about the physics about the rods. You don't need to do anything. So left, you see now the drag. So it can go from 0 to 10, the drag. So you can step your line. So I did it. I went right away to 10. Pew! And my line was totally broken. But that's not a problem in this game because you don't need to buy a new line. So you can just replace another line and you will be perfectly okay. So what I need to do now is I'm going to reel it in and you guys hear the clicking of my reel. So that means that is really good. I can maybe go to 6. But I need to watch it a little bit because if my drag is not clicking, it's a possibility that you break your line. So you can just do this too. So just reel it in. So I think that he needs to work a little bit, but he's doing it at the moment because I saw a YouTube video that he's working on the physics. Because you don't need to do a lot, you just reel it in and that's it. I'm not sure how it works on big fish. I guess on big fish that you need to go with a little bit lower drag, that you need to let them go the fish to get their stamina low. Because there is a stamina system, that's what I saw in this game. So the fish is pulling and the fish is getting tired too. So yeah, and the fish is already here, check. So what you need to do now is, here is a fish, and this is a little bit tricky, and I hope that he fixes it too, because you need to get the fish with your net, check. And this is not always easy. Now I'm very fast with getting the fish, but sometimes you need to keep pushing N until the fish is in the net. And it's a little bit irritating. But once again, I saw him working on the net too. For me, he can just remove the net. I don't see a benefit in it, but yeah. We need to watch it, but that's the cool thing. And now you guys can see what I mean. I got now my mirror carp is 3.8 kilograms. I got 80 coins from it, so I'm almost at 1,000. So I almost can buy my third rod. And you guys can see it at the right. You guys see the record. The record is for a guy called Caranto Porro, and he got 46.8 kilograms. That's 102 pounds. That's such a big fish. It's unbelievable. And only two guys got the maximum. I'm not even sure that's the maximum. Because it seems 0.8 is so strange number. So it's possible that you can go a little bit higher. And I see even names that I see in Fishing Planet 2. So that's My goal, I want to get that fish. To stop this video, guys, if you want to need help, just push F1. At the left, you guys see the time. That's the time, the real time that I'm now. At the moment, it's 2 p.m. in Belgium, the 24th of May. So, it's a fun game. If you want to try it out, I hope this video helped, guys. You're going to have a lot of fun with it, I think. After the update, it's going to be a little bit more fun too, I think, because a lot of new stuff is incoming. So I hope that you guys enjoyed the video. If you like the video, give me a like. If you like my channel, subscribe, please. If you go with Carp Fishing Simulator, have fun with the game. I hope to see you guys on the leaderboards, and thanks for watching. Bye bye.